State flags have become part of the national reckoning of cultural sensitivity and the historic treatment of Native Americans by white settlers. Ali Rogin is back to tell us how Minnesota is poised to get a new flag in May, redesigned to get rid of what one critic called a cluttered genocidal mess.
Atop Minnesota's flag, which has flown over the state for six decades, the phrase L'Étoile du Nord, the North Star. But critics say this flag needs a new direction.
It just was kind of a cluttered mess, and you couldn't really tell what was going on it.
In 2021, State Representative Mike Freeberg introduced the bill to replace the flag, which depicts a Native American man riding away on a horse as a settler plows the land.
The problems with the imagery on the seal are pretty incontrovertibly racially motivated.
For me as a Dakota Wiyan or Dakota woman, I felt the old flag was offensive.
Shelley Buck represents the Prairie Island Indian community southeast of Minneapolis. She was part of a 17-member commission set up by the Democratic majority legislature to choose a new flag and state seal.
It was important to see this flag change because this is our ancestral homeland. A lot of tribes throughout the country have a migration story to where they are currently. But for the Dakota people here in Minnesota, this is our place of birth. Our creation story tells us we come into human form from the waters here in Minnesota.
In fact, Native people have called this region home for more than 10,000 years. And today there are 11 federally recognized tribes with reservations across the state. Teacher and historian Anita Gall, who previously ran for state senate, also served on the commission.
Minnesota's current flag is what many people call a seal on a blue bedsheet. You know, slap your state seal on a blue bedsheet, which about 20 other states in the union have basically the exact same design.
The commission received more than 2,100 submissions, ranging from serious and symbolic to just silly.
Somebody submitted a picture of their dog, which went absolutely viral all over the state. Others had, and this is one of my favorites. So our state bird is the loon. And so some people submitted a loon, but with laser eyes coming at laser-eyed loons.
I remember when some of the funnier flag submissions came in, like the picture of the bag with the word B-A-Y-G written on it, or bag for the way apparently people hear Minnesotans pronouncing that word. I thought, oh my God, people are going to think this whole process is just a joke. But I actually think it kind of had the opposite effect, and I think it generated a lot of interest and public involvement in the process.
Minnesota wasn't the first state to redesign its flag. There have long been calls for several southern states to scrap flags with ties to the Confederacy. Mississippi changed its flag in 2020. Other states sought a more distinctive symbol. Utah's new flag becomes official next year. Illinois, Maine, and Michigan are also considering redesigns, also for design purposes.
State flags are starting to change for two reasons: removing offensive symbolism and improving the branding of the state.
Ted Kay represents the North American Vexillological Association. That's the formal way to describe a flag enthusiast. He also wrote the book Good Flag, Bad Flag. Kay says the winning design by 24-year-old Andrew Precker is a very good flag. The new design includes a light blue panel representing the state's lakes, a navy one resembling its shape, and a white eight-pointed North Star.
Minnesota's flag design probably would rate among the top 10 of U.S. state flags.
Now it will be one of those flags that people look at and they'll be instantly know, that's Minnesota. That's Minnesota's flag.
At the famous Mall of America, some fellow Minnesotans agreed. Others objected, very nicely, of course.
I mean, it's pretty decent. They could have added some, you know, little sparkle or bedazz. But it's pretty decent. It's not so bad.
I was hoping that it would really, you know, like you'd look at it and be like, there's Minnesota. And I don't get that from what was decided upon.
I think Minnesotans have a bit more personality than that. I think just the three colors, I think they could have put a little bit more thought into it.
In a statement, Precker said he hoped his design can finally represent our state and all its people properly. That was the commission's goal, says commission chair Louise Fitch, a graphic designer who represented the state's Council on Latino Affairs.
All of us, doesn't matter which party you are, socioeconomic, if you're a recent arrival immigrant, or if you've been here for generations and generations, or if you're American Indian, we all want the same. We want our government to be transparent. We want housing. We want our kids to have a good education.
The new design becomes official on May 11th, Minnesota's Statehood Day. a fitting birthday present for the North Star State. For PBS News Weekend, I'm Allie Rogin.